Hello and greetings from Iceland and a happy new year to you all. And the first update of the year includes not only interesting news from the Reykjanes Peninsula and West Iceland. This is also the video where I look into the new year and try to guess how it might turn out as for the geology of Iceland. And you can of course use the comment section to tell me your own thoughts about what is to come, but I'm starting with Grindavík, and the latest news from there indicates that the next eruption will begin around the turn of next month, a bit earlier than I expected, but my first guess was the second half of February, and it would not surprise me if we would be looking at a similar scenario as last time, or an eruption that will take place further northeast than the first eruptions, and the bulk of the lava will flow toward the Blue Lagoon. So I'm not expecting anything new, and some experts, likely not all of them, are of the opinion that this scenario by Grindavík is slowly fading out, and this will come to an end after one or two more rounds of magma accumulation. However, if the next eruption starts within a month and the magma inflow doesn't slow down first, I'm not seeing this coming to an end soon. So my guess is that we could experience 3 or even 4 eruptions near Grindavík in 2025. But this is not just about the number of eruptions. Will the infrastructure hold? That is the main question. And I'm talking about the lava berms around the Blue Lagoon and the power plant. They barely held the lava out during the last eruption. But as for Grindavík, I'm way more optimistic there, since it somehow looks as future eruptions have found the most effortless spot to erupt. Like, we hardly get any signs in the form of earthquakes before eruptions now, so I think it's only logical to assume that only a significant change in the pipelines under there could move the volcanic activity closer to Grindavík again. But as for the ridge, where it has been erupting lately, it has been growing upwards, and that means that the lava will flow faster during the next eruptions. So if the lava berms won't be ready, that could mean problems because we won't be able to control anything after this starts. And one of the biggest questions is of course, when will this come to an end by Grindavík? And we were always led to believe that when the Reykjanes Peninsula would wake up, we were in for some hard times for the next 200 years, definitely not non-stop, and I have spoken about that on my channel before. So I was a bit surprised recently when I heard a comment from Professor Magnus Tumi Guðmundsson. He is very careful when it comes to statements, and his version of the big picture is that the magma volume that has erupted in those 10 eruptions is close to the magma volume that came up during the first chapter of the last volcanic period. So he is more and less saying that when this chapter by Grindavík will be over, Mother Earth will give us a break for the next 100 years. But other experts are having a problem with this, like the research professor Ármann Höskuldsson. He feels as this is coming to an end by Grindavík, but the activity will take off to the west, to the so-called Eldvörp craters. And this is not for the first time that he is saying this. And this time he gave us a bit more explanations. He talks about the Sundhnúkar crater row, where those 7 eruptions have already taken place. And the plate boundaries, they are giving way there, because those craters are the edge of the Eurasian plate. And he is saying that the North American plate, it will also react. And that would be where Eldvörp are, but only time will tell if he is right. And I remember him saying also in an older interview that the so-called Krýsuvík system has actually woken up. So this professor is obviously far away from expecting everything to be fine when the Grindavík chapter is over and done with. And although I'm not a geologist and in no academic position to say who of those fine scholars are right or wrong, I believe that Professor Höskuldsson is closer to the scenario facing us meaning that we are only seeing the opening scenes of a larger event. And I have actually mentioned before why I think so. Ever since eruption number 3 in 2023 took place by the mountain Little Hrútur, we have seen the seismic activity struggle to move northeast into the so-called Krýsuvík system that includes Lake Kleifarvatn. And I would not be surprised if that location might be the next epicenter when it comes to the Reykjanes Peninsula events. And let's move to the other systems. And I'm starting in the west, where the so-called Ljósufjöll Volcanic system seems to be waking up. And this is the most talked about area these days, because a 40-minute long tremor pulse confirmed more and less that it is magma on the move there at 16 to 21 kilometers depth. It's not the tectonics that are teasing us, like many suggested at first. So the big question is, will the magma make it all the way to the surface? And I found a new interview with Professor Þorvaldur Þórðarson, and he has been saying that when the Snæfellsnes Peninsula wakes up, the eruptions seems to come up in clusters or a bit like the Reykjanes Peninsula. But while the seismic activity is so deep down now, there is no reason to expect an eruption soon. But we see this scenario intensifying little by little. And Þorvaldur mentions that after we see the magma reach the depth of 10 kilometers, or if it makes it up there, the probability of an eruption increases very fast, meaning that we might be looking at a West Iceland volcanic eruption, the first in over 1,000 years, and that could even start this year. However, I am not putting it on my list for 2025. The statistics, they still say no, although it is no way to say how this will develop. But I can however say that it is on my priority list to get more footage from there, and I want to do it soon, although there are some rough roads to make it to the earthquake epicenter in the middle of winter. But as for future updates, the footage will be worth it. And my next stop is at Hofsjökull Glacier that started to stir up some questions last year, or seismic activity still increasing. But I still think it's very unlikely that it will turn into something in 2025. And Hofsjökull Glacier is a scenario that could turn into something like Eyjafjallajökull that erupted in 2011. And the build-up to that eruption, it took somewhere around 16 or 18 years. So this seismic activity under Hofsjökull, it might increase, but this is not going all the way. And let's move to the more difficult systems. And what makes this so hard this year is the fact that we have five systems, major systems, I'm not including the Reykjanes Peninsula, and they are overdue or getting very close to an eruption. So as for the statistics, it would be the sensible thing to say that at least one of them will erupt in 2025. And the system I'm betting on as the most likely to erupt is Askja Volcano. And the reason is that Askja has been getting ready for little over 2 years now, with constant ground uplift. That development has been both definite and quite fast. We have heard everything from a moderate eruption up to a staggering amount of magma, which in its own tells us that scientists don't know what to expect. The last major Askja eruption occurred in 1875. It was very explosive due to pockets of groundwater, but what is different now is the fact that we have Iceland's deepest lake on the sunken caldera roof from 1875, a lake that didn't used to be there, directly above a magma chamber. And that could be a recipe for something different. And one of our experts mentioned last year that the Askja ground uplift has reached the point of no return. He meant that this amount of magma under there has only one thing left to do. So this is not about if, but when. But what kind of eruption we can expect, that is the big question. So I'm leaving a link to my full Askja video where I talk about the devastating 1875 eruption and its aftermath. And since Askja is not known to be a teaser, like many of our other systems, it deserves the first place as the most likely major volcano to erupt in 2025. But talking about teasers, the biggest teaser of all is Katla volcano. And I'm not betting on a volcanic eruption there in 2025, but there will be unrest there for sure. Perhaps even flood from under the glacier, but only as a part of her program, as a teaser, to keep us on our toes. So Katla will for sure be in the news several times, even giving me a reason to do a few updates, but continue to be a teaser. And not far away, we find Hekla. Hekla is the surprise volcano that only gives us perhaps 30 minutes notice, hardly enough to warn hikers. And as the time between eruptions there increases, the crazier Hekla gets. And it's been 25 years now since the last eruption. The average used to be 50 years. And such eruptions, with so long interval, were the eruptions that earned Hekla the reputation to be the gateway to hell. But everything changed there after the 1947 eruption. Eruptions became more frequent, and a 10-year interval seemed to be a new reality, or until now. So Hekla is still expanding, and we can expect just about anything there. It could be tomorrow, or after 25 years. That's my best guess. But a subglacial eruption does, however, look way more likely. And my guess is that the so-called Grímsvötn system, Iceland's most active volcano, will show its power in 2025. And the ice-covered caldera under Vatnajökull glacier has been inflating and sending us teasers. So I have already several Grímsvötn videos online covering the times when the volcano was just about to erupt. And what we want are those frequent and harmless eruptions rather than those nasty ones. And not all know that the Grímsvötn volcano is in fact the volcano responsible for the so-called Laki eruption in 1783. It erupted with such force over an 8-month period that the aftermath caused a drop in global temperatures. 120 million tons of sulfur dioxide was spewed into the northern hemisphere from a 25 kilometer long fissure that opened to the west from the glacier with at least 130 vents. So it's a nasty system, but lucky us if it erupts frequently in the caldera under the glacier, such eruptions are harmless if you don't have any airline stocks. And as for its neighbor, the hotspot over the mantle plume, Bárðarbunga, that some call the home of the motherlode, there was a noticeable increase in seismic activity there in 2024. The caldera is still inflating after a 65 meter drop after the 2014 eruption. That was just the first eruption of more to be expected, according to scientists. And the Bárðarbunga eruption will always be a major event, and Bárðarbunga and Grímsvötn are connected, so we could just as well end up with a subglacial eruption between those systems, like in 1996, the so-called Gylfi eruption. So I would bet on Askja and Grímsvötn as the most likely systems to wake up. But Bárðarbunga would not be a surprise, because that volcano has made its intentions very clear. And I have an honorable mention as well, and that is Reykjanes Ridge, near the island Eldey. Eruptions there have been way more frequent than eruptions on the peninsula itself, and we have a few good samples that tell us a bit about the past, like this volcanic plug here. And that eruption started on the seabed and migrated onshore during the 13th century. And that is also when the island Eldey came into being. And I see Icelandic experts mention an offshore eruption quite frequently now, because earthquakes there on the seabed are getting so frequent. And such eruption, it could mean lots of problems. This is very close to the Keflavík International Airport, and the ash cloud that formed during such eruptions, they could easily wipe out a part of our tourism industry for days or weeks. But I'm not putting this on my list of eruptions in 2025, just mentioning it because it's not a matter of if, just when. So when I include the systems on the peninsula, we have 9 volcanic systems getting ready for something. And at least 5 of them are so far into that process that it is hard to guess which one of them will erupt in 2025. And I believe that it will not just be the Reykjanes Peninsula that will be teasing us in 2025. At least one of the major systems will show its might. So this year could easily become a year of 4, 5, perhaps 6 eruptions. Or another eventful year. 6 eruptions last year. Unbelievable. But as for the channel and me, I hope it's going to be a bit more predictable year than last year. Although I will always have to leave some room to go after volcano footage. But this year does, however, look well for the channel due to how well equipped I am now. And I upgraded it to an 8K hybrid camera that allows me to use only one set of lenses. So I made a very practical choice in order to get as much as I could for the budget. And the third and the last camera lens in this upgrade, it came now in December, the zoom lens. And I was getting the rest of the sound recording equipment this week. Good enough gear for documentary production and excellent to do interviews for the channel. So I've been going through this upgrade little by little while I have been selling some of my older gear. And if it wasn't for the help from subscribers, this upgrade would have been impossible this year at least. So again, many thanks for your understanding and support. And I only wish I had more time for practicing now, do tests and such. But that will come as I move on. And I will move on when I start to see more sun. I'm getting a bit tired of this darkness. And this has not been a good winter to work with as for filming. But I'm hoping that it might change soon. And the first tour of the year will be Reykjavík and the Reykjanes Peninsula in a week or so. I need the new footage from the lava berms or the B4 footage, which I will need for comparison when the next eruption starts. And then I will have to go there back again. But I also want to visit West Iceland, the epicenter of the earthquakes. I have lots of summer footage from a nearby valley, and that footage is ready to be edited into a long video that will be online next weekend, shot from my car and my drone, and I will edit that video together with music. But I need to get closer to the epicenter, and the roads to get there are the reason why I got the good old Land Cruiser a year ago. And as for my prediction for 2025, I might be wrong, of course. And that is okay. This is done for fun. And again, feel free to tell me what you think in the comment section and come up with your own predictions. But this is enough for now. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.